I treated urban planning not as a kind of sexy expression of drawings. It is actually a science. And this, of course, the combination of the hard software and very down-to-earth hardware together actually has helped Singapore. And actually, out of curiosity, I've asked about a dozen foreigners working here. I said, why do you leave your much bigger country to come to Singapore to work? All of them, without fail, within 3 seconds, to say, because everything works here. Yeah. So I think I think I'm taking opportunity partly to tell Singaporeans our becoming a world-class city did not happen by pure luck, did not happen by good intention. It's really a lot of hard thinking, a lot of deliverable action that can help us to achieve that.
And cities fail because?
Cities fail because you see, city as a profession is really very badly, very poorly understood. In fact, my urban plan does not get my clients excited because my plan is scientifically correct, but when you look at my plan, it's not sexy. So if you want to really get your client excited, it will produce a very sexy drawing with all kinds of beautiful colors, which not only have no meaning, but also tend to vandalize the environment city. But that is a kind of plan that gets people excited. So what happened now is that since people don't understand what is city planning, very few people, and therefore we tend to go for iconic projects. We tend to believe in sexy slogans. We tend to talk about future ready. But how can you be future ready if you don't even know what is present? So these are all the problems I were facing. But fortunately, our first generation political leader never once asked me to produce sexy HDB plan, never. You look at my HDB plan, they're dull as hell, but they all work. Okay. Actually, I just want to add, what we do care about the word iconic, except that our emphasis was not on iconic architecture or iconic project. Our emphasis was creating an iconic city. That's much, much harder, but it will be more durable.